Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. It's January. It's 21 degrees out. I'm not going to be out in my garden today. I have looked out at it, and it looks pretty, but I'm not out there. I am working on my spirit gourds, my dolls that I make out of gourds. And in one of my past videos, 25, I think, I showed how I was growing the gourds. And then later on, I showed how I took a long snake gourd, and using a hacksaw, I cut it into sections. And that's how I start my spirit gourds. Then I have to find an egg gourd or some other gourd that I've grown or found to make the little head, because I like my proportions kind of eggy and then section of snake gourd. So I've made a couple of these. In my, I think it's 68 video, I showed some of the spirit gourds that I have made. And I'm now finished with the body of this spirit gourd. This was my homage to winter and ice. And this is his little head that I've been working on, all the while trying to figure out, how's this one going to be different? What am I going to do that makes him different from the other ones? And I had found this little twisty pinnacle thing from a different gourd. It might have even been from some grapevines, and I had glued it on to the top of this. As you can see, here's the actual stem, but this I added on. And now that is going to go on here. Now, been thinking about all the things that I have, my found objects, my bought objects, and trying to figure out what would be special for this. And then I found that I had some very thin pieces of plastic that we bought in a pack years ago, never knowing what I was going to do with them, but today when I was looking, I found it. I decided to make this one a little neck piece using this little piece of lace plastic. And after painting the head, pointy head part, kind of like the Who's in Whoville, that's going to be my base for this. Then, years ago, I also found what's called paper cords. Mizuhiki from Japan paper cords. They look like pieces of wire, but they aren't. They're paper, and they're very workable. And they even taught me how to create my own tool for winding. It took a darning needle, chopped the top off so that you have something to use as a brace, and then you start twisting and turning and creating a cord. And you keep going until it's the length you want. Then you take it off, and it turns out like this. And these I'm going to be hooking into the headpiece like this.
Kind of like earrings.
Sort of like earrings, sort of like dreadlocks, perhaps, in the colors of the gourd. So they'll be silver and blue. Now, when I started, I had no idea what I was going to do with this. And it just kind of, it kind of progresses as you go along. At least it does for me most of the time. Let's see if I can get this one to stay in so you can see how it'd be looking. Okay? Haven't quite figured out what face I'm putting on it yet, or what kind of eyes, or if I'm going to put a mouth on it, or I'm going to do something else behind here, but this is how it works. You just do little by little and use what you have. So that's where I am today. I'll show you when I'm done.